I don't think this one goes another 3 minutes. The way Sing Tanoi looked in that first round, he is here to make a big statement indeed in his comeback. Tracking roundhouse kicks to the forearm. Now, what that'll do is cause Lussuri to drop his arms once they tire, once they get hurt, and that'll leave his head exposed for the round kick up to the neck. Good jab there from Sing Tanoi. He said with the four-ounce gloves, he would be more powerful than ever. We saw it in the opening round. Good knees on the clinch here from Lussuri. Then he breaks off.
He was trying to pivot away and create maybe a dump there, but you can just see the base of Sing Tanoi. Muay Thai athletes have some of the heaviest hips. It's almost impossible to take down a 300-match veteran like that because they're so heavy in their hips.
Left hook from Lussuri, bouncing up and down high on the ball to his feet. Should have thrown the right hand for company. There it is from the Italian. High lift roundhouse kick from Sing Tanoi. On the outside here, the tie. Lussuri spinning back elbow and a crossing elbow. Beautiful work there from Lussuri. And now the Italian putting on a show.
This is a much better round for Joseph Lussuri.
Lussuri's confidence is flowing here in the Lion City.
Oh man, look at his arm, Michael. It looks like a Ziploc bag full of hamburger. Those big kicks are just deadening that arm. That's gonna have effect as this match goes on.
Neither look for one man to execute a dump. No, referee Onari breaks them. What a start to this round from Lussuri.
Man, I am a fan of Joseph Lussuri. There is no quitting this kid. He is just full of heart and determination.
That cut has opened up a little more. We say a big hello to all of our fans, to those watching in Nashville, Tennessee. It's Austin Pierce, a big hello to you. And Dunley Tayabunja watching from Baguio City in the Philippines. That will be supporting all the team Lakai.
Lussuri comes racing forwards right in the middle of the cage, takes command of the distance.
After his outing against Sam Agang, Hadal didn't go so well. Lussuri, you feel, has really redeemed himself here tonight. There's a house kick to the waist there from Sing Tanoi. Now the tie is loading up the heavy artillery.
Sing Tanoi is trying to finish it. He's coming forward. There's another one of those elbows again.
Two elbows. The legs almost buckled on Lussuri. They clinch up against the cage. Do a little bit of a tango. Gut-munching knee there from Lussuri. He breaks off now. Thought about the front kick that Sing Tanoi goes with the hands to the jaw to no avail. Thrusting jab. There's the left cross over the southpaw stance of the tie. Kicks to the back leg.
The pressure of Sing Tanoi. Look at him faking that push kick. Coming in, that's where he slides in with that elbow. He fakes the push kick, lifts the leg up, and then slides in with the elbow. Big body kick to the arm again.
Those ribs of Lussuri must be hurting. They are damaged and bruised. We do score on damage in one Super Series, and certainly Sing Tanoi doing that to the forehead and to the body of Lussuri. Oh, it's off. Atsushi Onari has waved it off.
Joseph Lussuri, all hard.
Lussuri is devastated. He is very emotional here, but a good call, I feel, from referee Onari. Because Sing Tanoi inflicted the damage on Lussuri. What a return for Sing Tanoi Portalakun.
He came back, he beat stage 3 cancer, and now he beats another one of his toughest opponents, Joseph Lussuri. Look at this, beautiful spinning back elbow. Joseph Lussuri put on a show, throwing elbows of his own. Look at that, fake the push kick. There's that frame, oh, big left hand. He just kept opening up that cut a little bit too much. The referee was forced to stop the contest. Sing Tanoi comes away with another huge win to add to that already stacked resume, Michael.
Big cheerio to Billy Ackerley in the United Kingdom. I know that Billy enjoyed that one, as did we. I'm sure you all did, wherever you're watching around the world. Could that be the GoDaddy knockout of the night? Let's go to Dominic Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Atsushi Onari, has put a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 36 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of technical knockout, Sing Tanoi Portalakun!
What a return. what a message of inspiration to those battling or having battled cancer around the world. Sing to Noi or Telekun. This one should be awesome. Calm, the former golf prodigy. Will he swing for the fences on Yar Team and hope to land a knockout? Yar Team has been honing his kickboxing. Says that Khan leaves himself exposed. Amir Khan says Yaroslav is open to right crosses to the chest and solar plexus, followed by left hooks. Yar Team says second round, ground and pound, TKO. Southpaw stance on 22-year-old Singaporean Amir Khan. Switching stance now to orthodox, threads that left hand nicely, and back to southpaw. High kick from Amir Khan. He's lengthy, he's precise, and he's fast. And he just nails Yar Team with that left out of southpaw. Locks up the leg, can he hope for a driving takedown? Gets it on the check. Somersault backwards there from Yar Team. Front headlock here from Amir Khan. Drives the knees in. Nice work from the Singaporean, and they're back to their feet.
Team defends with a wizard there, but look at Khan's strength. Just got that body lock. Now he's trying to muscle him back to the ground. But good work for our team. He's spin him around, but Khan gets control again because he has that underhook on the right side.
Yep. 8-week training camp for Amir Khan. 3-month camp for Yaroslav Yar Team. Amir's corner telling him to keep the pressure on. Let's see if Yar Team can exercise some of that speed that he said he'd need to beat Amir. And Amir beats him with a punch with a beautiful straight left down the tube. Takedown there from Amir Khan. Doing everything right so far. Goes to side control. We'll look for a knee on belly here. Yar Team looks to control the posture of the Singaporean. Where does Yar Team need to go from here, Mitch?
He's got to move over onto his left side. He can't stay flat on his back like that. Khan's just got too much strength, too much pressure. But big bridge by Hard Team, but it doesn't allow him to change the position. It gets into actually a worse position here by giving up his back. Now Khan's working on both sides to get those hooks in. If he slides that left leg in, Hard Team's going to be in a lot of trouble.
Amir Khan, 100% finishing rate. Only one has come via submission. 6 by knockout. He's hoping to sub out Yaroslav Lair Team right now. Still has the back of Yar Team. Yar Team trying to find a way to his feet. Not a predicament that the Czech wants to be in.
No gloves.
Trying to wrap the arm around the neck of Yar Team. Showing a lot of patience here.
Half time.
Very methodical, Amir Khan. 2:15 remains in the first round. Fight. Both men swing with the hooks, neither connects. There's the shot to the chest that Amir Khan said that Yar Team was open to. Southpaw now from Amir Khan. Yar Team's got to beat Amir to the punch, to the kick. Two very big athletes in this division. Has the back standing now, does Amir Khan. Little back elbow just to let Amir know that he's here from Yaroslav Yar Team.
You can see Khan is just one step ahead of him in every single one of these exchanges.
Catch him!
A grappling exchange or a clinch exchange. Khan's just moving a little bit faster. Now he's trying to change levels, but he separates out. Expect that left hand to come again.
That was nice work from Yar Team. You saw Amir Khan drop levels to look for a double leg, and Yar Team underhooked him, stood him back up.
That left hand is landing over and over again. Oh, and he faces it. Oh,
there he is!
What a beautiful setup. He hit him again with the straight left hand through the high kick and then answered with a nice little right hook to put our team down. Beautiful finish. Let's take a look at that again. Boom, landed with the head kick. Boom, there's the right hand. Drops our team. Beautiful combination from the Singaporean Khan.
Amir Khan predicted a first round finish yesterday. He said the right hand
would be one of the weapons he'd used, and certainly it's the one that did the job to finish Yaroslav Yartin. Let's go to Dominic Lau and make this knockout all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match, we have Fan Jianling, General Manager of Shanghai Just Sports Development Group. And now, your referee, Mr. Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 46 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of knockout, Amir Khan!
A huge win for Amir Khan. A huge win for Singapore and for all of his fans also watching in Louisiana in the USA. Amir Khan maintains his wicked 100% finishing rate.
Good volume though from both men. Two more rounds to go. Muay Thai rules, penultimate round now. Crowd loving every moment of it. One super series. Big roundhouse kick off the bell from Sam A. And again.
Now this is the fourth round. This is usually the most important round in Muay Thai. So you guys can expect these two to put it all out there.
Oh, Sam A. Gaiyanghadao. More kick than a drowning horse here in the fourth round. Wilson's got to be careful. If he comes in, he's got to commit. Goes to the inside thigh again of Gaiyanghadao. Plenty of instructions coming from the corner of Sam A. Knee guard there from Sergio. Pushes out the front kick. Oh, you hear the pounding into the ribs from Sam A. My word. And Sergio Wilson taking the punishment and coming back. The cagey, sneaky, touch combatant.
Sergio Wilson's showing a little move, so you can see him take that kick and just start to ride it and walk with it from that power from Sam A. But a nice straight left hand.
Sergio tries to catch him coming in. Beautifully done there from Sam A. Gaiyanghadao. A little Muay Thai tricks of a super experienced veteran. Wilson ties him up, tried for the elbow off the right arm. Oh, nice dunk from Sam A. Muay Thai 101. The little tour, the pivot, the move.
Oh, the big kamosh! The big kamosh! He caught him swiftly, and down went Wilson.
Six, seven.
That was a huge elbow from Sam A. Gaiyanghadao.
Right as Sergio Wilson stepped in, the beautiful timing of Sam A caught him flush on the chin.
And now Sam A, the aggressive eater, is off the charge for the Thai legend. Inside leg from Sergio. Has he fully recovered from the knockdown? They clinch up against the cage. Sam A again, devastating on the inside. Knee from Sam A, elbow. High left roundhouse kick. Wilson's taking heavy shots now. Sam A tags it. Uppercut elbow. And another one. Oh, he dropped him again. Second knockdown from Sam A. Getting him down. This is crazy. This is awesome.
The heart of Sergio Wilson brought him back to his feet. But again, Sam A was just too much. That right there, Michael, is my vote for the GoDaddy knockout of the night. I don't know if it's going to be official, but look at this. Look at that. Caught the kick, waited for the right moment. Perry stepped inside, and boom, another left elbow on the chin. That was the first knockdown. This is the second, straight left hand, caught him with the up elbow. But then, look at that, wobbled him, caught him with the left, and then hit him with the right, and that was the one that crumbled Sergio Wilson to the floor. But what an amazing match.
Muay Thai excellence in excelsis from Sam A. Gaiyanghadao. 366 career victories, and that was an all-time great knockout. That is why one Super Series is amazing. Sergio Wilson put up a fantastic contest. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
To present the belt for this match, we have Ms. Yvonne Ng, Senior Chief Operating Officer, Yunnam Hair Care. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Atsushi Onari, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 47 seconds in the fourth round for your winner by way of knockout. And the first one Super Series Muay Thai Flyweight World Champion, Sam A. Gaiyanghadao!
History in the making here in Singapore. The first ever one Super Series World Champion is Sam A. Gaiyanghadao. What scenes here in Singapore? That was an awesome, crazy knockout.
All good? Jenny, all good? All right, back. Jenny, back.
At this point in time, right. She's obviously right, running away with the fight, Jenny? So Jenny's gonna have to do something, fight. Something way different in her game plan in order to make a difference here.
Wow. We continue the proceedings here. Round three, 5 minutes on the clock. Jenny Huang, no doubt, landing several convincing counter strikes there at the end of the second stanza, but the evidence of all of Lee's work, Mitch, over time in 2016, showed off with the kickboxing.
Yeah, you gotta wonder when Angela's gonna change this up and try to get this fight to the ground, because, but at this point, like Rich said, it's basically target practice. She is just picking her shots and really just using Jenny Huang as a punching bag, but there's no quit in Jenny Huang. She's continually moving forward, and she's answering right back. Look at her throw!
And more shots continue to come in as Angela Lee hits a beautiful short elbow there.
Nice pressure up against the cage, but Jenny's doing the right thing. There we see the Lee family, Ken Lee and Christian Lee, egging on Angela Lee, trying to get her to push a little bit harder. One big flurry, one big shot, and this fight could be over. But there's another nice little short elbow.
And more combinations from close range as Angela turns up things here and continues to try and force Jenny Huang backwards. Huang, though, patient, trying to pull the counter, trying to time something, looking for that Hail Mary.
Yeah, we can see Jenny's been, you know, absorbing a lot of shots, especially to her face, but there's not really any significant damage shown on her face. So she's either got, like, just skin made of absolute leather, or, you know, maybe she's evading these punches and really slipping a little bit more than we're realizing.
Yeah, you can see the way she turns her face to avoid at least the majority of that power. And more importantly, I think what Angela wants to avoid here is punching herself out, Mitch. She's got to be clinical.
Yeah, you got to wonder, does she have the gas to do this for five rounds? But we've seen Angela go five rounds, five hard rounds in one of the most entertaining fights we've had in one championship. So I believe she's got the gas tank to continually do this, but she's got to be careful. Now she chooses to take this fight to the ground. Beautiful head snap takedown there.
Excellent control there from the front headlock position. And Lee, now with 2.5 minutes on the clock, certainly has a number of options from this position.
But Jenny Huang is very skilled on the ground as well. That judo black belt, she recently got her purple belt in Brazilian jiu-jitsu. So I don't see her making any mistakes, but Angela is just so unorthodox on the ground. It's hard to pinpoint exactly what she's gonna be doing because she consistently transitions to so many unique things.
It's certainly beautiful attacking jiu-jitsu for MMA at its finest, and a lot of good positional control here on display from Lee to try to open up the back take, but Huang blocking right now, and just one hook in there, Mitch.
Yeah, but look at the way she's controlling that arm, the things that she's doing to that right side arm, the way she's trapped the left arm, interlaced the legs, and now she's just able to tee off.
Very impressive ground control from Angela Lees. Look at that left arm just pinned behind her back, and she's free to just unload with the right side.
As Lee utilizes that wrist ride, the way she's holding onto it with her left arm, Huang bearing the weight and unable to escape this position.
Flattens her out, that's it, that's it!
Whoa, it's a win for Angela Lee, and still champion of the world.
That was an impressive finish. The control on the ground was a thing of beauty. She interlaced the hand, pinned it to the side of Jenny Huang's body, and just got the TKO stoppage. There's that check, beautifully blocked leg kick right there from Angela Lee, and just chose to unload with the hands. Beautiful win from your champion, Angela Lee.
And there, that head snap, that was key. Spun, took the back, and never compromised position. This is where it all really was, Mitch, the beginning of the end.
Yeah, she was able to lock that hand in, pin it to her body. Jenny Huang couldn't defend, and there's the tap to strikes. Beautiful win from Angela Lee.
And she stays inside the ring, the champion, Angela Lee, celebrating there with her family. We'll have the decision here momentarily, but what an incredible capstone here tonight in one championship. Rich Franklin.
I'll tell you, at the end of that fight, it looked like Angela was actually gonna set up for the twister again.
Well, the decision is in. We'll hear it all from Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Olivier Costas, put a stop to this fight after 3 minutes and 37 seconds in the third round. For your winner, by way of referee stoppage due to strikes, and still one women's atomweight world champion, unstoppable Angela Lee!
We're ready to rock and roll. Second round set for five for the World Lightweight Championship. Defending champion, Shinya Aoki. Ready?
Round two.
The challenger, the 20-year-old phenom.
Oh, nice left hand, right hand there landed by Shinya Aoki as he jumps in for a big hook. Oh, good sprawl there by Christian Lee as he rushes forward with some hands.
Christian Lee comes in and within 3-7 knockouts, 4 submissions. 100% finishing rate. Comes in off back-to-back first-round wins of his own over Kazuki Tokodome and Edward Gallagher.
It's a 50-50 position. One hand under, one hand over the arms. Now we're gonna see Shinya Aoki start to turn. He's gonna start to create a little bit of chaos. Good job by Christian Lee. I'd like to see Christian Lee wait for Shinya to come to him, because you know what Shinya's gonna do. Shinya's gonna try to shoot him for that takedown. That's where Edward Fuliang was able to catch him with that knee, is when Shinya came to him. Want to wait for him to come to it. He wanted to go to Aoki. No fear in the warrior as he was able to come forward and hurt him with the hands. And the Lees have two world champions for kids.
Shinya Aoki called out Christian Lee. Be careful what you wish for. And look at the sportsmanship. Look at the martial arts code of honor. The respect. But Christian Lee just beat down his idol. Can you believe it? Christian Lee is the lightweight champion of the world. At 20 years old, he stops the tremendous run of Shinya Aoki.
Nice.
That left hand was the beginning of the end. And then watch, Aoki goes down, right hand cracks him on the jaw, lines up a scooping bolo punch. Look at that right, and that left, that did the damage.
See Shinya start to wilt a little bit, and then Christian jumped all over him.
She seemed like he wasn't quite out of it yet, but the referee thought differently as Olivier Kosh jumped in and stopped any unnecessary punishment from Christian Lee, as Angela Lee is emotionally breaking down as her brother is going to be crowned the lightweight king.
And Michael Phelps will put the belt around the waist of Christian Lee. What a moment for Christian Lee. Let's go to Tom Lau, my word.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the belt for this match, please welcome the one and only swimming legend that is Mr. Michael Phelps. Joining him, the CEO of Lou Global, Mr. Kit Wong. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Kosh, has called a stop to this contest after 51 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of technical knockout and new one lightweight world champion, Christian Lee.
Amazing scenes in Singapore. The gold over the ring and the gold over the shoulder of Christian Lee. Michael Phelps presenting the belt